So, hygienic robot for food handling is about, as you know, KUKA has a very wide range of robots for every possible payload and reach you can think of. But recently, we've also introduced what we a new series of robots, which are basically standard robots in a special variants, which are called hygienic oil robots. And perhaps some of you have already mo noticed this in LinkedIn or on our web page or somewhere else, and wondering what's all this about. And these are robots especially dedicated to the food industry of handling food stuff. But as we typically say, KUKA is so much more than only the robots itself. Within the food handling industry, KUKA actually provides a complete and thorough concept for the complete chain of food handling, from the intake of supply of raw material to the handling of that raw material to feed it into a handling and processing chain with hygienic robots. Again, then picking and packing those produced items. And finally, palletizing them and distribution. And we will look a little bit closer into what this total concept consists of. But it is not only food that these concept and these products are suitable for. They are equally suitable for pharmaceutical or cosmetic industry, which have similar cleanliness and regulation demands around handling as the food industry has. If we dive deeper into what this concept actually consists of, it is these hygienic oil robots I shortly mentioned, and we will dive deeper into what that is in a little while. It is also a set of hygienic machines, and you might wonder what the difference between hygienic oil and hygienic machines are. And I will get back to that as well, but shortly it means that the hygienic machines are actually allowed to have direct contact with raw food. We have a palletizer robot suitable for freezing rooms for frost applications. It can stand in sub-zero degrees environments and work there, typically freezer rooms and so on. Of course, we also have in this concept a set of SCARA robots for fast pick and place applications. Furthermore, of course, the standard and palletizing robots as well. But it's not only robots we're talking about here. There are external equipment such as 2D and 3D vision systems for finding and placing the parts. Of course, this also comes with a lot of softwares to make this work together. So one of the softwares we have is for conveyor tracking, which allows us to handle the materials without stop and pause of the conveyors, that we can follow a moving conveyor both when we're picking and when we are placing objects. There is another software pack called Pick Control, which, like we often do in the food industry, handle very fast flow of materials. And one robot is simply not fast enough to handle the material flow. Then we combine several robots in and we use them as one. The system will automatically disperse the loads between the robots we have included. Of course, we also need to pack and palletize the products we are producing. And we have a very nice software for this called PalletTech, which lets you automatically create pallet patterns and very flexible without any prior programming knowledge. Once the pallets are ready, we need to transport them. And as you know, KUKA has a product scope of automatic guided vehicles, as we call them, KMPs, KUKA mobile platforms. And of course, we also have software for traceability, for connectivity into the cloud or to higher level systems, as in food and medical and health industry, traceability of products are extremely important. And we also have a set of very advanced simulation software, so we can test our simulation flow, our product flow, our robot movements before we make any changes or even build up the concept at all. And finally, but not least, of course, we can also provide training, application expertise, product service, and support worldwide to any customer here. So this should not be set regarded as a set of different products, but actually as an integrated solution that fits the total needs throughout the food handling process, from intake to output. And that makes us pretty unique in the market, that we can provide a total concept using standard products without any special applications for the complete supply chain in the food, pharmaceutical, and cosmetics industry. If we now go into these hygienic oil robots, which I mentioned before, what they actually are standard robots. So it's part of our standard program. It's not completely new robots. It is our existing robots, but with some adaptations. And they are available for every type of purpose. That's handling, packaging, palletizing, and stacking applications typically. And these robots actually have a FDA compliant lubricants in all axes. That means that we run no risk of contaminating any foodstuff, even if there should be, if we are so unlucky, so there would be a leakage from the robot of some kind. These lubricants are fully FDA compliant. We will not cause any health risks to anyone. And of course, they are IP65 and 67, so they are washable. And they are even equipped with a very special coating, which allows us to have a very easy and very effective cleaning of the robots. If we look to which robots are available in this product range, it is from the smallest KR6, the 6 kilo robot with a reach of 900 millimeters, up to the 240 kilo robot with a reach of 2.9 meters. And there is also a set of palletizing robots, and now from 140 to 240 kilos in this hygienic oil range. That means that right now there are 12 robots available in this range. In my prior slide, I also talked that we have something called hygienic machine robots. And this is the next step in cleanliness regarding food handling. These robots, and we actually only have two of them right now, the KR10 kilo robot with 1100 reach, and our Delta robots. But the difference between the hygienic oil machines and the hygienic machines is the level of cleanliness. This is one step further. These robots are actually allowed to handle raw meat, raw fish, directly without any barriers between the robot and the foodstuff. They are based on an EHEDG design guidelines and therefore allow the direct contact with foodstuff and pharmaceutical substances. Of course, these also have FDA compliant components and lubricants. And they are built out of corrosion resistant housings, and there are no sharp corners, so they are very easy to clean The Delta robot is completely in stainless steel, for example. And they have IP6567. And in the case of the Delta robot, the picking head up here is even IP69K, which allows us to clean it with steam or special chemicals. And this is one of the big challenges within the raw food handling industry, that they are frequently and regularly cleaned to get rid of bacteria and so on. Therefore, we also need robots that can withstand this. I shortly mentioned before that we have a set of softwares, and this half hour here will not allow us for the complete spectra of going through the complete program of softwares, which you saw before, but I'll mention a few. One of them is our ConveyorTech software, which is a software not only dedicated to the food industry, but highly usable in the food industry. It allows us to track and trace the speed of the conveyors bringing in and out material of the operation in question. So we can automatically place or pick up foodstuff from these conveyors without stopping them. The robot will follow the movement of that conveyor, regardless of the speed it will move in. This is a simple and easy software which takes care of a lot of programming issues. The other one is our software for PalletTech, palletizing. That is a software which allows us to create automatically palletizing patterns with just some graphical interfacing. And typical for the food industry is that the product development is really fast. That means also that there is a continuous need to change, add, or adapt the palletizing layer patterns. And this is exactly what our software PalletTech allows us to do. Without any knowledge in robot program, operators can directly create new palletizing patterns for new products. That is done directly in a graphical way from the smart pad of the robot. Equally important in the food and drug industry is the ability to track and trace data concerning the products and keep that tracked data for a longer time. The KUKA robots have this connectivity possibility to directly feed data into your systems, or will through MQTT, the Internet of Things standard protocol, or the industrial standard protocol OPC UA. Every parameter of the robot, every parameter we have created in our programs, such as batch numbers or whatever, can directly be fed into higher level systems from our KUKA robots without any further programming required. This topic is a rather big topic. We have produced a white paper, which can be downloaded directly from our webpage. But I have also included that and uploaded here to the webinar today. That means that if you look in the GoToWebinar panel, there is a tab called Handouts, and under that you will see this PDF of this application, this white paper describing what I've said here in a more careful way, which you can download now, or as I said, if you watch the video recording of this webinar, you can download it at kuka.com and just look for food applications and you will find this white paper. As I mentioned, I will not go through all the softwares required. The important thing here is actually to realize that Our products, like the hygienic oil robots, are especially adapted for the food industry, but they are also part of a totally integrated, so to speak, concept for food handling, which consists of a number of special requirement robots, but also a number of special requirement softwares, which can be combined in an easy way to meet the requirements of you or your customers. And we are here to discuss these applications.
Industrial intelligence.